Folks, let me be clear. Now is the time. Now is the time that we must bring to closure the conversation about Marcellus Trail extraction tax or local impact fee. And that's what you see here today. You see Senate Democrats and House Democrats working together to position and poise legislation as we go through this process to bring into effect a local impact fee on Marcellus Shale. We've talked about it for 3 years now. First year, 2 years ago, when the Governor Rendell proposed it, it didn't make it through the process. And then last year, we put language in the fiscal code that said we would adopt a Marcellus Shale tax, and we did not. And again, we're here this year. We all know that folks throughout this Commonwealth strongly and sincerely believe, more than three-fourths of the folks in Pennsylvania believe, that we need to have some form of a Marcellus Shale impact fee or extraction tax. Folks want the industry to be part of the solution to rectify some of the problems that are taking place in our local communities, not only the infrastructure impact, but also the environmental impact that has taken place over the course of this past year and will continue to take place unless we do something now. And that's what we're talking about today, a united front working together to do what we can to put into place a Marcellus Shale tax. There are a number of folks here today who are going to speak about some of the issues that we're talking about or some of the details of the things we're talking about. So it's my honor to turn the program over now to my colleague from Allegheny County, the Democratic leader of the House of Representatives, Frank Dermody. Frank.
Thank you, Jay. And it is great to be here today. And it's great to be here with our colleagues from the Senate to join together on such an important issue. And I think what Senator Costa said is correct. Now is the time for us to finally make a decision on our fair and reasonable Marcellus Shale tax. The people of Pennsylvania support it, and it's needed. The industry is doing well. They're drilling all over the Commonwealth, but there are impacts across the Commonwealth that need to be addressed. Local communities need to have their problems solved, the conditions that are hurting their roads, that are hurting their water plants, their water treatment plants. It's occurring throughout the Commonwealth. We need to make sure they have the protections, and that can only be done through a fair and reasonable tax. We're also supporting legislation that's the same legislation that includes environmental protections that are not anywhere found in any of the other bills. And it's very important that we join together to make sure we protect our land, we protect our water. So we're here today to say we join with the Senate in making sure that we can implement a Marcellus Shale tax that covers all the problems we have with the environment, local impacts. And this is a statewide issue, so it has to be done statewide, and the revenues have to be addressed statewide through DEP, DCNR, and other environmental areas where it's important that they have the financing, that they have the resources to make the environmental protections that are required. So I'm happy to be here today with all of our colleagues from the House and the Senate to make sure this happens. Now I would now like to introduce our minority whip, Mike Hanna, who will also talk about some of these important issues.
Thank you, Frank, and thank all of you for being here. We're very pleased to join with the Senate Democrats to come together on a proposal that will result in a meaningful tax on the Marcellus Shale. That's our biggest concern, that we have a meaningful tax and that we also do environmental protections. And I believe this proposal does that. As this proposal has been developed, Senator John Udicek put together a compromise, and I'll let him describe that. Senator Udicek.
Thank you very much. Here we are on the eve of another budget in Pennsylvania without the discussion of a Marcellus Shale tax in that final package. As Senator Costa mentioned, 3 years, no Marcellus Shale impact. It's hard to comprehend, it's hard to understand. Let me just lay it out for you. Ray Walker, Vice President of Range Resources, Chairman of the Marcellus Shale Commission, said in an article I read today, we are ready, the industry is ready to talk about a severance tax or an impact fee. Leaders, the two leader Senate Republican leaders have both introduced Marcellus Shale impact fee or severance tax proposal. House Republicans have introduced proposals on a Marcellus Shale impact fee, and of course, Senate Democrats and House Democrats have led the charge for the last 3 years to make this part of the budget. There's only one person who has been outside of that debate, and that's the governor, who wants to wait, who wants to study, who wants perhaps never to sign an impact fee or a severance tax. It comes back to the idea of who do you take an oath to? When I took the oath in the Senate chamber, that was to the Constitution of Pennsylvania and to the United States. I'm not sure if we're interested today more in honoring pledges to think tanks out of Washington, D.C., or whether we want to uphold that oath to the citizens of Pennsylvania and the citizens of the United States to protect and to preserve our environment while growing our economy. Being a son of northeastern Pennsylvania, I can tell you we waited too long to get responsible about extracting coal. We cannot wait too long to get responsible about the extraction of natural gas in Pennsylvania. What we have done, we have taken the ideas from House Republicans, Senate Republicans, anybody that had a good, responsible idea on the severance tax or impact fee on Marcellus Shale, we have put that together in a package. We unveiled it last week. We've joined with the leaders in the House and many of the Southeast Green Dogs from southeastern Pennsylvania to advance this idea in these final hours to try to make headway, try to make sense out of this Marcellus Shale impact fee. I'm looking forward to continuing the debate today, tomorrow, and for as long as we need to in this week, in this budget negotiation week, to get it on the table. 70% of Pennsylvanians want it on the table. They want to see the natural gas industry grow, but they do not want to wait on an impact fee or a severance tax on this industry.